Leona Marais.
Oh! The bricks feel different on the spine. This is it. If you know, you know. If you didn't, you know now. It's not a shock to Adriano. It's not a shock to those that have seen him dominate one championship over the last few years.
The body is not supposed to bend that way.
He's in deep on that choke.
That's out. That
done.
It's over.
Knocking out Demetrius Johnson was the crowning moment of Adriano Marais' career. But winning world title bouts is nothing new for Mikino. Marais was the inaugural one flyweight world champion all the way back in 2014, and no one has matched his success in the division since then. Marais was undefeated when he arrived in one as a 24-year-old.
Nice kick.
But he lost his O when he debuted as a bantamweight.
Now, here we go. Oh, he's on his back. This is going to be the end. He's in deep on that choke.
That's out.
Done.
He's tapped and it's over.
He belonged at flyweight, and he reaped the rewards as soon as he returned to his natural division. Three trademark submission wins later, and he was the world champion. Marais had proven his warrior spirit by bouncing back to claim the biggest prize in mixed martial arts. And that was something he would do again and again. Though his first reign ended at the hands of Khairat Akhmatov, Marais rebounded with two more submissions.
That's deep, that's it!
And then reclaimed the belt in a huge rematch. Then, when Jehe Eustachio snatched the title via a controversial split decision, Marais never complained. He vowed to settle the score in a rubber match that capped one's historic first world title trilogy.
A five-time world champion, Marais. A two-time world champion, Eustachio.
Not standing statically and still in front of Marais.
And you know that Demetrius Johnson is watching this one. He'll have to go through the flyweight Grand Prix to get a crack at the eventual champion. We have more than 110 martial arts world champions here at One Championship.
Marais walk forward. Jehe's typically a counter striker. He got a beautiful left hook, but there's the first takedown of the match.
He's taken Marais' best submission attempts in two matches so far.
Beautiful job by Jehe to dig with the underhook, scoot onto his side.
Oh, climbs the back. There's Marais. Gonna take him for a ride. Backs Marais against the cage. Here come the right hands from the challenger. Scooping in the uppercuts. Riding the back of Jehe Eustachio.
Jehe's got to be careful in this position.
Still on the back. Is this more draining on Marais or more draining on Eustachio?
Well, I would assume the years of experience that Marais has, he's going to be fine in a lot of these positions. He has stamina in his legs. Oh, he goes underneath. He's attacking the arm. A little bit of hand fighting. He's going to try to separate the hands on Jehe's grip and then spin into him. Oh, but Jehe tries to turn the corner on him, but he gives up top position in the process, and now Marais is on top.
Nice elbows off the back here from Jehe. Tries to open up the money box. A nice push off from the champion and an up kick.
He's got to be careful. These kicks are going to allow Marais to pass the guard.
This crowd rallying for Jehe Eustachio. Eustachio tries for a choke. It's deafening. The boom shakalaka.
Look at these transitions from Marais. Oh, and Jehe is the one to end up on top. Adriano turns into him, and now Jehe is looking for a hook on the side.
Pandemonium here in Manila.
You can see he was attempting to go for the choke right there, at least control the head, create a little bit of space, but now you can see Adriano realizing the time is running out, and he's gonna try to flurry with the ground and pound. Jehe's trying to stop him there.
What a round! Eustachio throws the legs up. The final seconds, a scramble. Marais tries to take the back. Two rounds down, this is awesome! What a back and forth contest, a brilliant second stanza. Nice low sweeping leg kick there from Eustachio. Good outside leg kick, short left hand. Beats him Marais to the punch here. Still a striking contest here.
Adriano's starting to push forward and do some work on his own though.
Little short left hand there. Resets himself, nice skip up inside leg kick. But I like and again, getting that femur profunda.
Because when he's allowing Adriano to dictate it, but a nice duck under, takes the back.
Oh, this is more like it. This is Marias' world. This is Adrianoville. He's got the back of the champion, and he's going for a ride again. What can Eustaquio do from here, Dragon?
Well, he's trying to shake him off the backside, but he chooses to stand back up. You can watch Adriano's going to triangle his legs together, snake one leg underneath the legs there. Now we're back to where we were in the beginning of the second round.
Marias said he'd be like a spider. Is Eustaquio stuck in the web here? It looks like a demented game of Twister. A submission attempt from Adriano Marias. Referee Olivia Coast right on top of the action. Have a look at this.
Oh.
Oh, my word. Have a look at this.
The body is not supposed to bend that way.
What pain may Eustaquio be in? His face isn't showing it. The flexibility of the champion. I've never seen this before. How do you get out of it? The spider's web. This is amazing. Have a look at this sub attempt. What do you call it, Mitch?
Look at him, he's trying to knee bar. That's basically a rear naked knee bar, I think is what he's trying to do.
Looking for a takedown, gets a takedown to Marias. Now let's see the survival skills. Let's see the defense. Eustaquio back to his feet. No, he won't, goes inside the guard.
And new one flyweight world champion.
Marias was a six-time one flyweight world champion, but he came into the biggest match of his career as an underdog. The watching world expected Demetrius Johnson to live up to his reputation as the greatest of all time and add the one world title belt to his collection. The Brazilian had other ideas.
Adriano wants to use his striking. He wants to keep this match on the feet, start touching up DJ and utilize that length advantage that he's got.
Goes clockwise once more, the champion. Hooked to a cross there, gut-munching knee from Demetrius Johnson. Tie clinch and a high knee from DJ. Adriano been using a lot of the circle to move Johnson around, make Demetrius come to him, and Demetrius missing with those punches. Body kick. Just bludgeoned that into the body of Demetrius Johnson. The crack reverberated around this massive stadium. And now McKinnor, the champion, on his back and looking to throw those legs up.
You can see Adriano's trying to lace up those legs, possibly going to a heel hook submission right here. He traps the leg in Ashigarami. Now he's got an exposed heel hook on the outside. Let's see if he starts to threaten it. DJ needs to create that space. He needs to get exactly what he needs to do. Good job to fall into the guard, but Adriano was immediately jumping on top.
It's been in favor of Adriano Marias. Once again, this bout will be judged in its entirety and not round by round. Inside the closed guard now of DJ with under 1 minute to go. Both men just testing with the hands, dipping their toes in the water now with the leg kicks. You sense a little bit more mustard behind both of them here in the second round. To his left in the opening round. Good glancing right hand there from Demetrius Johnson. Staying out of reach of the hands of Demetrius. Almost walked into a high knee there, did DJ. He got caught by Marias. Top position now for the champion. Throws a knee to the jaw. DJ's hurt. It's good night, Irene! Adriano Marias defeats Demetrius Johnson.
Marias always had the BJJ black belt skills to grapple with anyone. And now the world knows he has crazy KO power too. But will he risk striking with the flyweight division's biggest hitter when he defends the belt against Yuya Wakamatsu at 1X?
Look at that left hand from Wakamatsu.
One thing is for sure, it would be a shock to see this match go the distance at the biggest show in martial arts history.